fellow galactic family. May the blessings of love bring peace to their bodies, minds and hearts. Time is to replace the noises of the mind with the softness of the heart. For a long time, mankind has walked through a harsh process of observing life from the linear mind. The mind, my children, which is a sacred instrument granted by God, to live and understand the three-dimensional environment. I know that many of you do not understand what I say, because, throughout your existence on this planet, you use your mind for the very maintenance of life. For it is what enables them to survive the physical body, to feed themselves, to take care of themselves physically, to love human beings, and not to perpetuate themselves in experience through the union of bodies. But it is time, my children, for humanity to take off from this control and open itself to the feelings and sensations that lead them out of this pattern. Planetary change in the environment in which they live may be one of the harshest of all cosmological history. For souls had never entered such a powerful mental process, to the point of completely abandoning the mastery of the gifts of eternal life. The world comes to be explained, planned, understood, proven and not felt. More than that, it is little lived. For in this mental environment they are inserted, men close themselves to the greater truth, that truth to which the mind was designed not to feel. Humanity closes to the feeling of the heart and rationalizes life, controlling it and closing it in a box of few surprises. Children of the heart, life is greater, it is magic, and within that mental box they have imprisoned, there is much universal help that their vibration is able to move. You move all possible help through your love, your emotions, the vibration that radiates from your heart. At that moment you simply free yourself from the mental box you have imprisoned and perceive the light that exists within you. You open yourselves to the benevolence of God's love to all children. Observe, beloved children, how mental the world is in which you live, only feeling how much you are still attached to the pains that surround you. How, my children, you are bound to the illusion of matter, desiring the goods for yourself, desiring the lives of others, dreaming of material happiness, when all this will never satisfy you, because what you really seek is in the love of your hearts, in the eternity of life. It is a hard process, that of three-dimensional life on Earth. Because he takes away the mastery of his soul and puts them at the service of a collective mental process of fear, restraint, and quarrel. Therefore, said my son Jesus, in one passage of his earthly life, that it would be impossible to serve two gods, the material and the eternal. For the God of matter dwells in the mind, in what you believe and teach. But the eternal God is he who trusts in universal wisdom and love, so that from this conjunction there may be faith and peace, with devotion to God. It is the mind of children. It is the mental process, which leads them to the hardships of life, for the way of the heart is light and soft, for it judges, criticizes, hates, loves and accepts with confidence and faith in life. What I tell you, children, is that you abandon the restrictions that matter and the ego imposes on you. Abandon fear, because fear and ego are the aspects that judge and place restraints on your walks. The abandonment of material experiences completely, to live the experiences of the soul, will not bring the necessary learning to its evolution. For the feeling that moves the putting of restrictions is the ego, it is the fear and the arising of judgments. Fear, children, need not be part of your walks. You find for a moment the path of light and lightness, the path of peace and fullness. And they end up moving away from the experiences of matter because they sustain the fear of being lost among the impulses that are brought by material experience. But they end up parked in their cycles of evolution, for they close in a reality where judgment prevents them from learning and evolving. All beings, all experiences that are brought through living in matter are denied and therefore end up being closed to learning. They are, children, dear ones, preventing you from galvanizing your process of learning and growth. Material experiences must be experienced, but with the heart, always following its divine purpose, with the radiance of love. The situations that occur in your lives and that, for a moment, cause them repulsion and judgment, should be looked upon with love and welcome. You must serve your truth, which is what vibrates in your hearts, and which is beyond material experience. From this point on, serving the material will no longer exist. For you begin to live material experiences lightly and anchoring all learning in the heart, allowing love to make decisions and guide their lives. Inserted in material life, they are traveling through the learning valleys, the schools of lessons, and the falls that will bring growth and greater elevation. But all these experiences, when you accept them to be fully lived, will add much to your growth and planetary evolution, for you will bring the possibility of illuminating these aspects connected with matter, in the points that reach you, and also radiate throughout the field that this aspect reaches, in all of humanity. And know, my beloved, that the only purpose of your life on Earth is to detach yourself from this collective mental process, abandoning the restrictions that have entered the world. In so doing, you will be strengthening your essences every day, so that everything in you stands out from your own light. They will be opening to the eternity of life, and understanding the world in which they live. I leave you to reflect on this process in your lives, because I am Mary, your mother, and I anchor the mission of giving your hands to guide all who are still blind to feel the reality of the soul. It is not possible to serve God and Mammon. But it is possible to serve God and welcome Mammon, with love, so that the material experience may be raised to the divine. Be at peace, my children. I am Maria, your mother.